Hello, welcome back. Today we're going to be discussing In Cold Blood by Truman Capote. This was a pretty interesting book. It's actually a true crime story of a murder of a family in Kansas and then about the capture and trial of their killers. I was extremely impressed with the book, the way it was written from many points of view. Even the killers, and that it went into such detail. Mr. Capote actually interviewed many of the townsfolk, and he got transcripts from part of the case, and so he was able to just really put this together. It felt like you were reading a story like this couldn't be what happened in real life. It was so good. So I really liked it. Absolutely fantastic. So in relaying a letter to a friend in jail, Perry, who is one of the killers, tries to better understand what is meant when his sister wrote him. His friend said, quote, "How would she feel if she were compelled to hustle her living on the streets? Would she still be all forgiving about the people in her past? Absolutely not. Nothing is more usual than to feel that others have shared in our failures, just as it is an ordinary reaction to forget those who have shared in our achievements." I get it. I totally get it. I mean, it may sound weird, but I get what he was saying. That just kind of stuck out to me, so I had to share that with you guys. One of the other things, not to be disparaging, but how could the family of Dick, who was the other killer, not even somewhat put two and two together, that they, you know, had no inclination that he was like that? Were they just that ho-hum? Did they literally have nothing on in their head? And at one point later in the book, the mother relates to a reporter that, quote, "We're plain people, just country people, getting along the same as everybody else." And so that made me wonder, does that mean that most country people are inept or just not prone to excess thinking? Which I know isn't right, but sometimes you see some people from the country, sorry, and you're like, there is not much upstairs. What? I'm from the country, sort of. My mom and dad were both raised in the country. Sorry if I offend anybody. Also about Dick, he was a real talker all the time. Blah, 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 blah. So remember what I was saying in my review of the book, Quiet, about how I thought that people who were talkers were just dumb and they talk to make themselves feel important and have other people think that they're important too. But also one thing I would like to point out is that his parents said up to a certain point Dick was a good kid, a nice guy, did well, you know, school, blah, blah, blah. But he did have, I think, a car accident or something, and it was an injury to his brain. And after that, he became different. So, I mean, you know, traumatic brain injury definitely does a number on you and can change everything about everything and about you. You know. CTEs, chronic trauma encephalitis, you know, it can totally happen. You don't have to be in football or anything else. Brain injuries just can do weird things to you, or they can do nothing. It just depends. And maybe that's what made him, you know, change. You know, it could be. Maybe if they had more medical knowledge back then, he could have maybe gotten off because of that, you know? Who knows? So while waiting for the trial, waiting during the trial process, Perry was asked if he'd like to consult with a local priest, and he said, quote, "Priests and nuns have had their chance with me. I'm still wearing the scars to prove it." And so it made me question, why do people in the clergy feel it necessary for corporal punishment? I just don't understand. Do they get off on it, or is it that's what was told to them is the right thing to do? Are they kind of like trying to do an eye for an eye kind of thing? I don't understand. If y'all could enlighten me, that would be great. And then as to why he did it, Perry, who was mostly the instigator of the murders themselves, said, quote, "It wasn't the fear of being identified or because of anything the Clutters, who were the family, did. They never hurt me like other people. Maybe it's just that the Clutters were the ones who had to pay for it." And again, I get it. You know, you get pent up aggression and emotions and feelings, and you can't let it out, or you don't know how to let it out properly, and you blow up. And a lot of times it's not yourself that you hurt. Not that I'm condoning what they said or did, but I do understand. So this book, 1 out of 5, I would definitely do a 5 out of 5. It was amazing. It was really, really well written, and I'm really glad I read it. I can't believe it took me so long to read it. I wish that more crime, more true crime at least, were written in this way. It was just really fascinating and interesting. So, the next book that we're going to be reading is called Before I Go to Sleep by S.J. Watson. Looks pretty interesting. It's fiction, but it seems like a mystery thriller type of thing. I like it so far. It's interesting. We'll see how it goes. So if you have any questions or comments, feel free to ask away. You can also share this if you like it. And I will talk to you guys later. Bye.